Israel to go to a city called Nazareth and find the house where a young woman called Mary lived. When Mary saw the angel, she was frightened, but Gabriel told her to not be afraid. God has sent me, he said. God has chosen you to be the mother of his baby. He will be a wonderful baby, and his name will be Jesus. Mary was surprised, but she smiled at the angel. I'm happy to do whatever God wants, she said. Mary had promised to marry a carpenter called Joseph. Joseph heard that Mary was going to have a baby, and he began to worry about what he should do. God knew that Joseph was worrying, so he sent an angel to visit him. When the angel arrived, Joseph was fast asleep, so the angel slipped into Joseph's dream. Don't worry anymore, the angel told him. This is God's baby. And when he is born, you are to call him Jesus.
Thank you. 6. The stable was not very far from the fields where the shepherds waited after the sheep. It was nighttime and very dark, but suddenly the sky lit up. High above them was an angel surrounded by light. The shepherds were very scared, but the angel told them not to be afraid. He said, "I bring you the most wonderful news. Tonight in Bethlehem, the Savior of the world is born." And he told the shepherds how they could find the baby safely wrapped in and made in a manger. Then, just as suddenly as the first angel had came, the whole sky was filled with angels singing. They sang, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, this is the end of good will towards men." Then, when the angels had flown back into heaven, the shepherds rubbed their eyes. "Let's go to Bethlehem," they said. "Let's go at once." And they left their sheep and hurried off to look for the stable.
Thank you. Thank you very much, children.
Oh, my,
wonderful sharing of the gospel message.